You got me on Baker and Brady lost and Mahomes and Rodgers did win. But all that mattered yesterday was how about them Cowboys? They are back.
Oh, they're back now.
Back in the saddle. Back in contention for that solo number one seed in the NFC. Here we come, baby.
I'm just trying to figure
out.
You're the only guy that could do this. Managed to lose like three other games and then make the one game that you won.
All that matters is this team.
What about OU?
Huh? What about them? That was Saturday. That was ages ago.
How dare you say that?
Okay, what about OU? Okay, yeah. I remember you said that.
Yeah.
Ooh, I mean, Lincoln Riley should be fired. He should be fired, but that's beside
the point. Yeah, you have the
Yes, his Cowboys got the win.
I see you guys haven't learned your lesson, still letting the Dak Prescott play late in the ball game. But I gave him a two.
A two?
I gave him a two, Skip.
Huh?
And the only reason I gave them a two is that they did what they were supposed to against a really bad football team.
Really? I got to get a new TV.
No, you don't. Because here's what the Atlanta Falcons rank. They're last in sacks. They're second to last in QB hits. They're 28th in scoring. Mm. They're 27th in takeaway. Only two teams allow a team to convert third downs better than the Atlanta Falcons.
Mm.
That's what you were up against. I would like to think after that shellacking, that lambasting that you took last week, I would hope you come out motivated.
Huh.
I would really hope so.
Huh.
And then you're playing Calvin Ridley, still their best player. He hasn't been there in a long, long time.
Mm. So I think Kyle Pitts is their best player, but go ahead.
Okay. We'll disagree. Kyle Pitts may be on his way to becoming, but I think Calvin Ridley right now is a better player. But that's neither here nor there, Skip. But come on, Skip. Atlanta, this is who they beat. They beat the Giants. Mm. You like the Giants?
Yeah, they're coming along. Have you been watching lately?
Oh, goodness. Now they're coming along.
Huh? Well, they wiped out Carolina, and then they beat the Raiders. I don't know. They're starting to come alive.
This is what you do. Hmm. And this is what you tried to get me to do, but I was very steadfast.
Huh.
You tried to get me to there's a reason why Foxbet and the Vegas bookhouses had them as a double-digit underdog.
Mm.
And they never moved off of that. It didn't move. Let me take that back. It moved from 10.5 to 9.5.
Yeah.
So, in other words, they were still a two-score ball game.
Mm-hmm.
And what you tried to do is that you tried to build it up. Because if the Cowboys win, you're like, they beat a good team. They beat the Falcons. No, they didn't. They beat a bad team. And that was a bad team that they played yesterday.
Mm.
I gave them a two because that's what you're supposed to do to bad teams, which is beat them.
Mm.
But let's not get carried away. I didn't dump sand on them last week.
Mm.
I didn't say Vic Fangio found a blueprint.
I think you ridiculed them last week.
I did.
Yeah. I think you dumped sand all over them. You dumped manure all over them is what you dumped.
No, that's what they left on the field last week. I didn't do that. But Skip, come on now. Give the Cowboys credit. The Cowboys, the offense, they got it going early. They got it going often against a very bad defensive team. And the Cowboys, what we know is that once they get you behind the eight ball, they get an opportunity to pin their ears back. They can come get you.
Mm.
They front run as good as anybody. You know that. Mm-hmm. I know that. But I gave them a two. I'm not finna go both feet on the bandwagon. It's like, oh, yeah, they back.
Mm.
They about to go to the Super Bowl. Because I still have them behind. If I look at the Packers, they let the defense looking real good.
Mm.
And I'm still believing. Now, the Rams come out here and play like I think they're going to play tonight.
Mm.
I still would have your Cowboys behind the Rams.
Mm.
Arizona have not had Kyler Murray or DeAndre Hopkins the last two games. They would be behind the Arizona Cardinals. So, at best case, and under the best scenario that I can surmise, your Cowboys would be the fourth or the fifth best team in the NFC.
Mm.
So, temper expectations down.
Mm.
Let it go. I mean, I don't want you to, you know, you was on suicide watch last week. But I gave them a two, and I ain't moving. I don't care what you say.
Okay, my turn. I'm going to give my team on the respect scale of 1 to 10, on the impressive scale of 1 all the way up to 10, I'm giving them a 10 for yesterday. I'm saying that was an A++ performance.
Against the
and
Falcons?
Right after the game, Jerry Jones was asked, when's the last time you can remember a better performance than the one you just saw? And he thought for a while and he said, I can't remember. Neither can I. I saw nothing wrong yesterday after I saw everything. everything wrong just 7 days before in the same stadium at home against your sorry Denver Broncos. I told you 1 week ago at this moment that it was an aberration. It was a blip because my team did not take your team, your old team, seriously enough. And they came in and allowed Vic Fangio to beat his chest and gloat about, we found the blueprint. He didn't actually use the term blueprint, right. But he basically said, we knew how to beat them. We knew how to shut them down. Well, maybe he needs to try to find a blueprint for shutting down Philadelphia at Denver yesterday, because you got your doors blown off at home by the Eagles, for whom you have little to no respect.
They got ran out of the
Jalen Hurts lit you up yesterday. Devontae Smith ran you off your own field. Thank you very much, Vic Fangio, for lighting or relighting our fire. I wasn't sure how my team would bounce back. I thought it would bounce back mightily, but I'm going to remind everybody that the Atlanta Falcons had just gone to New Orleans, the same New Orleans who had just shut down Tom Brady in that same Superdome.
Well, that's not that big
and
of a thing.
Beat them 27-25. And guess what Matt Ryan did against that vaunted New Orleans defense that shut down Tom Brady? He threw for 343 yards, 2 touchdowns, and no interceptions, and led the week with a 94 QBR on a scale of 0 to 100. What did my defense do? The defense that you ridiculed all week, the defense that you said, I told you so, it got exposed. No, you got exposed yesterday by my defense because it shut down Matt Ryan, who had thrown for 343 at New Orleans. Matt Ryan yesterday went from a 94 QBR at the Superdome to a 9 QBR at Jerry World. A 9 QBR? My defense rose and shone. I told you, my defense might not be star-studded, and we just lost our one on-the-rise Pro Bowler. I predicted before the year Randy Gregory would make the Pro Bowl, and he was right on Pro Bowl arc until the dreaded calf pull shut him down. And I don't know. He's not going to be able to play at Kansas City. Maybe he'll be able to play the next week. But he didn't play yesterday against a Matt Ryan that I thought would eat us up. Because if you give Matt Ryan time, he is still plenty good enough to wear you out, especially with Kyle Pitts finally having a coming out party at the Superdome. And here we went, and there you went. Your Atlanta Falcons, you still have a home in Atlanta, went 1 for 11 on third down.
Yes.
1 for 11?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
And would you believe Russell Gage, who had a really good game at New Orleans, would you believe he got shut out yesterday? He had 0 catches on 3 targets after he caught 6 for 74 at the Superdome.
Wow.
So all of a sudden, Micah Parsons, I keep telling you, he's the runaway defensive rookie of the year, but are we sure he's not in the conversation for defensive player of the year?
He might be.
Because he had another sack yesterday, and once again, he led them in tackles. He had 6 solo tackles. He had another tackle for loss. He is everywhere. I think it's Mahomes. They're going to Kansas City this coming Sunday. I think you just need to put his hand in the dirt. Just let him rush Mahomes because he's unblockable. He's becoming Charles Haley in the 1992 3-4 seasons for the Dallas Cowboys. So I'm saying, okay, what's not to love? How about Dak? He came off his worst game as a Dallas Cowboy, his worst ever career game. And what did he do? He came right out of the chute and looked like $1 million. No, check that. He looked like $75 million, which is what he's making this year, because he was flawless from the start. Did he miss a throw all day?
He's playing a bottom feeder when it comes to defense.
Well,
if there's something ailing your offense, one of the things that the doctor's going to dial up is says, okay, call the Atlanta Falcons and talk, check back with me after the next week. And that's exactly what happened. Skip, you know the Falcons aren't any good. Now, you told me last year, I remember it was a Sunday night game, when you guys did a demolition on the Philadelphia Eagles on a Sunday night. You remember that game? You said that had been the most impressive game, considering what the Eagles were representing.
Yep.
Now you beat the Atlanta Falcons, who are bottom feeders. They're not going anywhere. They're going to get a top five a top 10 draft pick. You know that. I know that. Now you come out here hooting and hollering, crowing.
They came in hot. They came in super confident. They came in thinking we have turned the corner. And what happened, if we could see what started to happen, how about the first 3rd and 6 from the Atlanta 13? Can we see this play, please? This started it off. Dak says, I got this because I got guess who? Who is my favorite receiver? Who have I told you from the start of the year has become Dallas's number one receiver? Who is the go-to? It's 88, who is wearing that number proudly. 88. It's 4 to 88. It's becoming like Aikman to Irvin back in the day, right? Yeah, 8 to 88.
I don't know what he's doing.
Okay. And yet, what was the biggest change yesterday? Would you believe Cedric Wilson had a banged up shoulder during the week and he was still active for the game? He played one snap. What did that mean? That CeeDee Lamb went from wide receiver to slot receiver, where he was as a rookie last year, and Atlanta could not cover him as the slot receiver. That's a key change, and I love what Little Ced did for this team over all those games that Gallup was missing, but Michael Gallup was back yesterday, and all of a sudden CeeDee goes to the slot, and CeeDee was uncoverable.
Yeah, Skip, I mean, he's okay. Getting third or fourth receiver, a DB that's covering him, so okay. I hope he'd be uncoverable.
Okay, I love that. So then let's switch it around to your Atlanta Falcons. They quickly faced, it's a 7-3 game, they face a 4th and 7 at the Dallas 32. And what does Arthur Smith do? He says, I'm going to go for this. What did he say after the game? We knew how explosive Dallas was on offense, so we just decided we got to go for broke.
Right.
And basically, they went broke on this play because look what little Jordan Lewis did. Jordan Lewis might have had his best game as a DB. He had a great one against Drew Brees a couple of years back.
That's a curse.
Yeah. Except,
that's Jairon Curse.
Wait, I thought this was play Jordan Lewis. I'm not sure we have the right play because it was to Gage. It was to Gage, and Jordan Lewis jumped in front of him, knocked the ball down.
That was Curse there.
Okay, all right. So now let's move to the first Dallas. Remember, they went for it on 4th down against your Broncos, and they missed every time on 4th down.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Okay, here's the first 4th and 5 at the Atlanta 33. And who does Dak go to again? He goes to his slot receiver. Yep, there we go. And he breaks away. He's as good as run after the catch as you'll find in the league. And let's go to the next 4th and 3. The next 4th and 3 comes at the Dallas 25. And guess who is back this time? 4th and 3, where are you going to go? Oh, yeah, I remember. Oh, that's still CeeDee. Let's go to, here we go. I remember this guy. I remember Dak moves. Boy, his calf looks just fine. Michael Gallup is back. So we finally have our three-headed receiver monster back for the first time since opening night at Tampa Bay. Thank you.
In all those things that you showed, what did Dak have? Time.
Yep.
They weren't close to the quarterback.
Okay.
They're last in sacks. They're second to last in QB hits.
Mm-hmm.
So what do you expect? No team, only two teams allowed the opposing team to convert third downs more than the Atlanta Falcons. And you're up here crowing about that.
I don't know how the Falcons beat the Saints at the Saints after the Saints had beaten the Bucs.
Well, you know what? We're about to find out. How did Washington football team lose and lose and lose and beat the GOAT?
We'll talk about that.
Exactly.
You're acknowledging he's the GOAT, finally. Finally, you admitted it on live national TV. Thank you.
I'm just saying, Skip, you know the Falcons aren't any good.
Mm.
If they were any good, why did everybody have them as double-digit underdogs? Mm. And it didn't move.
They were 9-point.
Wow. A two-score game in the NFL.
Yep. Okay.
So what does that tell you, Skip?
Well, I don't know. People still buy into the Dallas Cowboys, but I was pretty nervous about this game.
I wasn't.
Okay. Well, you also predicted that the Cowboys would blow out the Broncos the week before. Were you right? You were dead wrong.
I also predicted they would blow out the Falcons. Was I right or was I dead right?
Yeah, I think you just hoped that
Why would I hope
they would? Well, it covers you both ways. You could say, well, I thought they were, you know.
Thank you for watching. You can subscribe here to get the latest from the show and be sure to check out more of the best clips from Undisputed or go watch a few other segments from our other shows on FS1.